today we'll be sending a video of me making burgers, and please comment down below and give some likes. Don't want any thumbs down, and let's begin the video. But before we begin the video, I would like to show you this video that went wrong in the actual burger making. So yeah,
this is what mine looks like after I've mixed flour.
That really did happen. So let's get on with the show. To make burgers, we need to get all our ingredients. So we need to get some turkey mince, quite a lot of it if you're doing per four persons, some chorizo, pepper, tomato puree, salt and pepper. My mum will be helping me today, and the next step is washing our hands. And before we get started, let's wash our hands.
Wash your hands, scrubby dubby dub dub. Wash your hands, nice and clean.
Put off the top of your pepper and empty it. Like so, and then you empty it in the bin like I just did, so like this, and then you have to cut it.
That's knife is really sharp.
And be careful, knives are really sharp, so might need an adult for advice.
I'll show you how I'm cutting it.
And need to cut it so it's
very
nice,
small.
Very small. Like that. So yeah, so the pieces need to be like that. Very small. So yes. So next up is to empty the turkey mince into the bowl. Can be any size bowl whatsoever. So start. So I'm gonna open the packet and be careful. Scissors are very sharp as well as knives, so be careful while you use
scissors. Are very sharp.
Use the scissors to cut the mince if they're in big blocks, because some of the mince can be in big blocks. So I'm gonna cut open the packet like so, so I can get into it, and then, like I've just done here, I've sliced a bit of it open and then gonna drag it. And of course, after you've been touching raw meat, you should always wash your hands, because we don't want your hands being smelly.
Yes, so not cross-contamination
contamination. So look at this. And it can food poison you too. So all you're gonna do is squeeze it into the bowl. Maybe it's cold for it's just been in the fridge. So you're just gonna squeeze it into the bowl and mix it up. Mine has just been in the fridge, so it's freezing. Okay. Just put out the other packet. And the same, you're gonna squeeze and then it'll fall into the bowl, and then keep on squeezing. Now you're gonna mix it with your hands, and then, no, it might be cold, so the best thing to do before you make your own burgers, best put in, take them out of the freezer before, And yeah, so yeah. So now, if you like, you can get a, you're gonna get a spoon, and you're gonna mix it with a spoon. It's gonna be a hand thick, so hard to mix, but you still can mix it. So you're gonna mix it, and now you're gonna put all the ingredients into the bowl. All the ingredients. So, doesn't matter whatever you put it in, but I like putting them in at my own thing. So first, tomato puree, and you need 1 tablespoon of tomato puree. Squeeze it in there till it gets to the top, like this. And to pat it down, I use a little spoon. And so, just gonna pat it down so you know it's the right amount. Like so. So you can see, but I'll move the bowl out of the way. So, put it down there, and then I've got to put a bit more because you need to get to the top. And yeah, that might be enough. So I'm going to pat down and swirl it maybe a bit. And there, that'll be enough. So now, put the lid on the smart pure, maybe just scoop a bit in the bin. Yeah, so that's how much we need. And put the lid back on the top. I'm going to put this into the mixture. If it's hard to come out because it might be sticky, use that spoon and get it in. And now time for mixing again. You're gonna mix all that up with your turkey. And then you're going to add your salt in. And you will need this much of salt. You need 2 twists. So 1, 2. Gonna mix it up again. Mix it up three. Mix it on the table or your hand, like this. And then you're gonna put some red pepper in. If you don't want any red pepper, I mean black peppercorn ginger, and you don't have to, just, I'm gonna put some in just to give some spice to it. It depends on you how much pepper you want in. I'm gonna just do 1 twist because I'm not a fan of pepper. And you can do 2, 3, 4, whatsoever. I did 2 because I thought 1 didn't come out as much. You can smell it though when you're baking. I just thought that was enough. It's a bit spicy. So like that. So it'll be perfect as you might. And now you need your tricks. You need to put in your pepper before that tricks I just serve. And like, you need a full pepper, 1 pepper, and if you...
Is there any jobs that you'd like me to do?
Yeah, and while you're waiting, you can cut this one. So Mum's just going to cut the chorizo open, and while I mix all this together. So if you like a tomato burger, you can put more tomato, like 2 teaspoons or 3. We put in 3 because we thought it would be better. You did see me put in 1, but I thought maybe to add a bit more to make it more tomato because I love tomatoes. And everybody would. So this is what your mixture should look like after you mix it really fully. So this is what mine looks like after I've mixed fully. Because do not eat it.
I feel sick.
having to squeeze all of this together, and it's freezing because it's just been out of the fridge, all these stuff that is in here. Oh, my hands are going freezing, so I'm just squeezing it fully together.
So I pop the some of this chutney into
here. While my mum's pouring in the chutney. This is what a chorizo should look like. All cut up into small pieces. And then you put it in there, and then you're gonna squeeze it all together, making sure there's no bits that are not right. So squeeze away.
Now, how do you think that looks? Do you think we should add a bit more, or?
I think this looks all right, Mum. And cooks should always have a taste test.
Of the chorizo?
Yeah, the chorizo.
The chorizo is safe to eat.
Yes, the chorizo is safe to eat.
We'll just be going to get a left shot, pretty.
And if you want more, then you can cook. Like, well, you can. So, yeah.
That's still a flavour.
I'm gonna now add a bit more salt and pepper. So, two more of these. Like that. Shake it. Make sure everything's in there. And you see, it looks a bit like snowflakes have just gone on it. And then we're going to mix it with a spoon if you like. So you don't have to put your fingers in again.
I like to add a little bit of paprika to make a bit of flavour, not too much because it's quite a strong spice. So we just
just a little bit of paprika in, and that's a lot of paprika.
Because it's stubborn quantity.
And you're just gonna mix it in. Paprika is quite spicy, so if you're not a spice fan, do not have lots.
It's not spicy.
But
it's just a strong taste.
But it's really strong as well. It's a bit spicy. If you have that spice taste and you know what it's like, you know that it's spicy. To the people who do that. And pepper. Some of us will be thinking, I hate pepper because it's so peppery. Well, whoops. I'm just going to put two more shakes in. Shake. Twist it.
Well, that's such a big quantity, it's not, you don't taste it.
Yeah. And then that's enough, because last time I put in two, remember? And my mum's just going to have a good check.
It looks good.
See if it's
and
really
then
good.
We're going to shape our burgers.
Now it's my turn for the burgers. I'm a bit scared, as you can tell. My mum's just going to put the oven on, and if you're unsure of like what temperature it should be at, it should be at,
let's tell you,
should be at
180 Celsius, a 350 Fahrenheit or gas mark 4.
Yeah, and cooking time is 20 to 25 minutes, so all you need to know. So now my turn, I'm very scared. I'm just gonna shape it into a ball like my mum said. So I'm gonna just roll it. At school I might have done something like this. I can't really remember off my top of my head. But I think it's actually best to shape it on like ground because you can see it a bit better. And you've just got to encourage them peppers, like my mum said, to stay in. And it is really sloppy at first, so it's hard to really do it. So yeah, and then this looks a good one. So that's what mine looks like. Gonna show my mum just
well,
to
that's
see.
Fabulous, yeah.
Good. And I'm gonna now put it on the plate. Get me. We've made more than we expected. We made 15.
Then, so just getting the lovely burgers out. Delicious. And help
burgers. Smells really nice. I'm scared and nervous because it might be not nice. So let's take a bite.
Mmm.